because somebody hurt you, or maybe because you feel like you've failed one too many times? Have you ever felt like you're disqualified or never were qualified because you're not big enough, you're not strong enough, you're not good looking enough, or you're not intelligent enough, and you feel like because of this, God can't and won't use you? Well, my name's Gideon, and today I want to tell you my story in hopes that it'll encourage you to see that God uses anybody that's willing, even somebody like me. So with that, let's begin my story. At the time I was a young man, I was living in my father Joash's household. We lived in Ophrah, and the Israelites had all been enslaved to Midian for about 7 years at this point. And we were forced into hiding in the hills, in the mountains, and caves, wherever we could to get away from the enemy. It was Midian, the Amalekites, and some other people from the east that would come, and they would raid our fields, raid our lands. They would take all our food. Everything that we worked hard for, everything that we planted and watered and cultivated that entire year, they would just come, eat some of it until they're full, and then burn down the rest, wasting everything. So the only way we could get by was hiding our food, growing secret crops that they couldn't find. And so we were desperate. We couldn't go on living like this. We couldn't go on starving to death. We could only last so long. And the only thing we needed to do was to cry out to God, to Yahweh, because our grandfathers and fathers before us told us stories of how this God had rescued them out of Egypt when they were in slavery to the Egyptians. And God had raised up a leader whose name was Moses. And Moses was their representative and came to the Pharaoh and pleaded for the Israelites. And God sent down 10 plagues upon the Egyptians until they had no choice but to let the Israelites go. And even after that, the Egyptian army pursued the Israelites in their escape. And God parted the Red Sea. He parted the Red Sea so that Israel could walk through. And then once they reached the other side, he closed it back upon the pursuing army, drowning all the Egyptians. And then God led them through the wilderness and provided for them every day. He gave them manna and meat from birds. And without God's provision, they would have nothing. He even gave them water from rocks. And then God led them into the Promised Land, and there nobody could stand against them. There was no group, no people that stood in their way that God did not deliver to them. And so growing up, I heard all these stories about God, this Yahweh, the God of Israel, delivering his people. But here we are, 7 years of bondage to the Midianites and these other people, and it seems hopeless. God had sent a prophet to us. I never saw him, but we've heard rumors. And he said that the reason that we're in bondage is because we've disobeyed and because we have worshipped Midian's gods, Baal and Asherah. And so, with that, we're pretty much hopeless, feeling like the only God that could help us has abandoned us because we have disobeyed him. So that's a little background to this story. One day I was in a wine press, so it's a pit in the ground, and it's made out of rock, and usually it's made for making wine. But I had to beat out wheat in this wine press where I usually do it on a threshing floor where the wind could blow all the chaff away. But instead I was down in this wine press beating out wheat. It was dusty, all the chaff was blowing everywhere because it's not flat where it can just blow away. And as I was working, I saw a man sitting in the distance, and he was sitting under a tree. And so I ducked down thinking, this might be a Midianite, this might be one of the enemies. He saw me, or I hope he didn't see me. And so I peeked my head up, and I saw that he was walking towards me. So I knew I'd been busted. So I walked out and waited for him to get to me to see what he had to say. And you'll never guess what he said. He came up to me and he said, "The Lord is with you, a mighty man of valor." And I said, "What? Me? Are you talking to me?" And then I answered him, "The Lord is with us. If the Lord is with us, then why is all this happening? If the Lord is with us, where are his mighty deeds that my grandfather told me about? How come we're slaves to the Midianites?" And the man answered me, "You saved them. I'm sending you." And I laughed, "Me? We're the weakest clan, Manasseh, and I'm the lowest of my family. How could I do anything to even make a dent in this oppression that we're facing?" And he said to me, "I will be with you. Do not be afraid." And in that moment, I began to realize this might not be any ordinary man. This might be God, Yahweh, the God of Israel. And so I told him to wait there as I ran off back to my home to prepare an offering to test if he was really God or not. So I got this offering together. I got a young goat and I cooked some unleavened bread and cooked some broth. And I brought it all back, and there's the man still standing there under the tree. I brought it before him, and he told me to lay it out on a rock. So I did. I took all the pieces of goat and the broth and poured it over the bread and goat. And then he told me to stand back, and he took his staff, and he touched the rock. And as soon as he touched the rock, fire engulfed the entire rock, and the sacrifice was consumed, and then he disappeared. And in that moment, I knew that I had been speaking with God. And so I was afraid because everyone had told me, if you see God face to face, you'll surely die. And so I was panicking, terrified. I'm going to die. I just saw God. But I heard a voice, the same voice that had been talking to me. And he said, "Don't be afraid. Have peace because you will not die." So that night, I laid down in bed, pondering all these things, these events that had happened through the day. My mind was still blown. And as I laid there, I heard that same voice again. And this time, he told me to go and bring a bowl with me and tear down the altar to Baal that our family had set up and to cut down the Asherah poles. And so I obeyed him because this is the only God that I have ever truly heard from, truly known, seen face to face even. And so I took a bowl, I took 10 of my father's servants, and I went at night because I was afraid of getting caught. And we pulled down the monument to Baal. We cut down the Asherah poles. And God told me to take the wood from the Asherah poles, put it on top of the altar that we built to God after that, and then sacrifice the bull that we used to God. So we did that, and then I went back to bed. I woke up in the morning, and these people ran in. They drug me out before this crowd of men, and everybody was yelling and accusing me of destroying their altar. So I'd been caught, and in that moment I thought, why would you have me do this if I'm going to die now? So I stood there, hopeless. I couldn't plead my case. I did do it. But my father, Joash, stood before everybody and said, "If any of you contends for Baal, you'll be killed before morning. If Baal is really a god, let him contend for himself." And at that, everybody dispersed and nobody touched me. And I'm still thankful for that day that my father saved me. And so, pretty soon after that, all the Midianites, the Amalekites, the people from the east had gathered in the Valley of Jezreel, which is just below us. And there was too many men to even count. There was even too many camels to count. And so I knew that this was the time that God was wanting to use me to defeat them. So I started calling out to everybody from my clan, from Manasseh, and from the clans around us, and gathering up men so that we could go and fight them. And as the men were gathering, I went over and went back to the place where I first talked with God, and I brought with me some fleece. And I set the fleece out on the ground, and I asked God, if you will deliver us, if you're going to do what you told me you're going to do, in the morning, let the fleece be wet, but the ground around it be dry. And so that next morning, I woke up, I went out to check the fleece. The ground was completely dry. I picked up the fleece, and there was enough water in it after wringing it out to fill a bowl. And so I still wasn't convinced. I didn't have much faith, as you can tell. So I wanted one more sign, because I was risking my life and all the lives of these men that are gathering with me. So I put the fleece out again. I said, this time, let the fleece be dry, but the ground around it be wet. So I went to sleep, woke up the next morning, went out to check. The fleece was completely dry, but the ground around it was soggy wet. And so I knew that God was with us. So with that, I gathered together all the men who had come, and we gathered at the spring of Herod. And there was about 32,000 of us, which was still not even close to the number that the enemy had. And God told me, you have too many men. So he said, tell anybody who's afraid that they can go home. And not knowing what God was thinking, but just trusting him, I told the men, if you're afraid, you can leave. And 22,000 men left. So there's only 10,000 of us left against this vast army that is countless. And still, God told me, you still have too many people. If you win, you guys are going to think that it's by your own hand that you won and not by mine. And so I said, okay, God, what do you want me to do? And he sent all of us down to the water, the spring, and said, I want you to watch everybody drink. And if they bend over, scoop up the water in their hands, and lap it like a dog, then they're going to stay. But if they kneel down and drink from the water by putting their head in the water, then they're going to leave. And so at that, 9,700 guys left, and I was left with 300 men, which wouldn't even scare this army at all. So that night, God gave me the plan. He gave me the battle plan. And he told me if I was still afraid that I could go down to the camp and see for myself that the battle has been won. So I took one of my servants, we creeped down to the camp and kind of spied along the outskirts, and I heard two men talking. And one of them was talking to the other, and he said, I had a dream last night. There was a cake of barley bread, and it rolled down into the camp, and it hit our tent, and the tent was flipped upside down and flattened. And the other man interpreted his dream and said, this is none other than the sword of Gideon, and God has handed the Midianites and all the other enemies into Gideon's hand. And so with this, I was excited. I bowed down before God in humility, knowing that he really had won the battle. I went back up to the men. It was still nighttime, and I told them the plan. I said, follow after me and do as I do. So I split the men up into three companies, 100 each, and we surrounded the top of the Valley of Jezreel where the enemy were camped down below. And each man, I'd issued a trumpet, a torch, and a jar. And we'd covered the torch in the jar and held the trumpet in the other hand. And like I said, I told them to copy me, do what I do. And so we stood there, and right between the middle watch, the shift of the guards, right when they're transitioning, I took my trumpet, and I blew it as loud as I could, and then all my men did the same. We took the jars off of our torches, threw them down into the valley, and held up our torches. And at that moment, we yelled, for the Lord and for Gideon! And at that, all the men in the valley just started getting into a panic and killing each other, slaughtering their own companions, their own soldiers, and running. They fled towards the Jordan, and I called all the army back that had gathered, the 32,000 some men, and we pursued them and cut them down. And that day, the Lord delivered us from the hand of the Midianites and Amalekites, and we cut down 120,000 of our enemy. And so, I hope that from this story, you realize that God can use anybody. He even used me. I was the weakest of my family. And my family was from the weakest of the clans. Yet God still chose to use me to deliver Israel out of oppression after 7 years of being enslaved to the Midianites and Amalekites. And he can use you too if you're obedient. Thanks for hearing my story.